Hi YouTube, welcome to another episode of the 100 days of Webflow journey. This is video 19 and today we're gonna make this circular text animation. This is a very cool trending animation and we're gonna use CircleTypeJS library to power this. So this is gonna be dynamic. Whatever text you write is gonna turn into this circle. Then we're gonna animate it using Webflow interactions and some CSS. This tutorial is gonna be filled with a lot of tips and tricks. So stay tuned, bear with me through it. I'm gonna walk you through everything step by step. So are you ready? Let's get to it. So what I have here is this page and I want to change this text right here into a circular shape. Now to do that, we're going to use the CircleTypeJS library. I'm going to leave a link to this in the description below so you guys can check it out. CircleType is a very nice light library that gives you the option to change your text into circular shape, and that's exactly what we want. And we're going to copy the CDN code. We're going to go back to our project and we're going to paste in this code here. Before closing body tag, always remember to paste in scripts before closing body tag because this will avoid loading issues on your website because scripts take time to get loaded. So it's best to put scripts before closing body tag. Let's go back to CircleType and let's see how we can initiate this library. Now, if we scroll down, we can copy this part of the code and then go back to our page. And here we're gonna open a script since this is another script. We're gonna open and close a script tag, and then inside it we're gonna paste in the code we just copied. And as you can see here, this initiates circle type and it initiates it on an element that has the ID, which we're gonna name now into circle text. And you can name this whatever you want. We're gonna name it circle text. We're gonna copy the exact name and save, and then go to the text that we want to turn into an arc, into a circular shape. So I'm going to select this one and I'm going to go to my settings and I'm going to add the ID of circle text, the one I just specified in the code. Now, because this is JavaScript, we can only see the updates on the live version. So let's publish and have a look at how this is working. So now if we go to the live version, you can see the text is into the circular shape. Now, this is dynamic, so I can add more to the text, delete some part of the text, and it will take shape accordingly. So let's say if I write transform all your ideas into reality instantly. For example, this is just an example to show you how the text is going to adapt. So if we go to the new page, so you can see text adapts, and this is the old page. Smaller, here it's bigger, and that's the difference. Now, if we want to animate this, we can use Webflow interactions or we can use some CSS keyframes. I'm going to use some CSS keyframes for this one. So I'm going to add an embed. In the embed, I'm going to add a keyframe. So I'm going to open and close the style. Now, I've made a couple of episodes on how to make CSS keyframes. I'm going to leave a link somewhere here so you guys can check it out. Now, in this case, we're going to make keyframes of rotate. Now, in order to use these keyframes, we're going to just copy the name here. We're going to save it. Then we're going to go to our element. And then we're going to add in the custom property of animation. We're going to add in the value of rotate, the name we just made. And then we're going to give it a duration. So let's say 7 seconds. Then the transition will be linear. And then this will be infinite because I want it to keep looping. So as you can see, it starts looping here in front of me in the designer, but it's not circular shape, so we don't see the actual animation. But if we publish and then now go to the site, you can see that it has this circular animation form. All right, so finally, we're gonna animate this on scroll. So I'm gonna remove this animation for now. And we're gonna make this a page trigger interaction because we want this to scroll across the page. So while page is scrolling, I'm gonna select an action, and this action will be rotate the text. Of course, we're gonna select the text first, and then we're gonna add a new action, and this will be rotate. Then we'll scroll down, and here we can specify that it starts at 0 and then it ends at 360 degrees. So if we view this live, you see that when I'm here, so it's rotating 360 degrees. Now I can multiply this by 2, so it takes 2 rotations. Or if I can multiply by 2, so if I, yeah, so it's rotating twice, that might be nicer. So if we save and then publish, we can see how this works with the circular shape. Go back, refresh,
see that now when I rotate, it's rotating with me. So that's basically it. If you guys like this video, stay tuned on the upcoming ones, and see you tomorrow on day 20.